Ricci and Campbell on the faceoff. Campbell wins it. Dehner sends it into the Merrimack zone. Takes a knot, hop, score! Jeremy Dehner sent it off the glass. It hit a stanchion. Goaltender Cannata came out of the net to play it, and it changed direction and skipped into the back of the net. The Riverhawks with a fluke goal tie it at two. Oh, my.
Joining us this intermission, Riverhawk defenseman and one of the heroes of the Riverhawks Thursday night win over Merrimack College. That is Jeremy Dehner. Two-goal Jeremy Dehner. Welcome.
Yeah, you know, it's about time, I guess, get a couple in there.
I was going to say, we haven't had a whole lot of puck luck, but Thursday night we got one very nice bit of puck luck.
Yeah, we've had our bounces go against us, and you know, it's nice to get something, especially a big goal like that, to tie it up. And it wouldn't happen again probably if I tried a lot, but we'll take it. You know, it gave us some momentum and got us back going on the right track.
It changes the whole mindset when it happens.
It does. I mean, especially a goal like that, that can be very deflating for the other team. You know, like just something like that, no control over it, and it goes against them. So it's deflating on them, and that's when we got to capitalize to get them down, and then we just drive them.
Face off of it, one puck comes back to you, and you're just sending it down the boards, down the glass, as a matter of fact. Did you actually see it go in the net, or are you sending it down and adjusting your positioning and getting a bump? I mean, did you end up following the whole flight of the puck?
Oh, well, it was all part of the plan. I mean, we practiced that day in, day out, four stanchion inside the blue line there.
If you tried, could you possibly do that again?
Well, I'll tell you, I gave a couple tries a day at the beginning of practice, but no luck. But, I mean, yeah, Soupy hit a nice win back, came back kind of hard, so by the time I got it, I just wanted to get it in, get it deep in their zone, and it hit the stanchion. I knew it hit something funny, and it took a bounce to the middle, but I really didn't realize it, so I saw their goalie scrambling back to the net, and once I saw that, I looked, and I saw the puck going right in the net there.
You have to pinch yourself. I mean, yeah, you see it, but did you believe it?
I just kind of stood there, like, you know, it's good for the team, we'll take it, but just kind of stood there, didn't want to celebrate too much on a goal like that, I guess.
It was the game-tying goal in the third period, some 48 seconds after, I think, Merrimack had taken what was their last lead of the night, and we would add to it later with Michael Budd getting a power play goal. You'd also gotten the Riverhawks' first goal in the evening on a shot with a little bit of a screen in front.
We had our power play chances, and it'd be nice to capitalize a little more, but, you know, we have a 5-on-3, and that's the time. If you get the opportunity to have a 5-on-3, you got to make them pay on that, and I was just walking a puck across. They left the shooting lane open, and I saw Benny. He was giving a nice screen in there, so I just let it rip. And you know, their goalies, they go down a lot, they seal the bottom of the net, so I just kind of wanted to get it up and force them to make a play upstairs. And just, I don't know, it happened to get through. Benny put on a nice screen.
A 5-on-3, is it in some ways tougher than a 5-on-4 in that they really pack it in front of the goaltender, and there seems almost to be a temptation to look for one more pass?
A lot of people try to make extra passes in a 5-on-3, and they do pack it in. It's tough to find the seam, but you just got to get the puck moving side to side and make the penalty killers move, and the more you make them move with puck movement, the lanes will open up.
The power play for this team has been terrific, hitting about 21% of the time, averaging more than a power play goal a game. What makes this power play so successful?
Well, I mean, power play, you got to work harder almost than even strength to get pucks and keep possession. And it's a big momentum shift if you can get some chances on a power play and get some good scoring chances. And the biggest part is just kind of, I guess, the breakout, getting in their zone and setting up. And I mean, especially with the new rule, I guess you'd start off with faceoffs. You know, you get the faceoff to start it down in their zone. And that's the biggest part right there. If you can win that and get possession right off the bat, then you're in good shape.
Now, you're out at the blue line, generally in the middle, or start at the left point, but move to the middle. You've got some decisions to make. How long can you wait to decide whether you're going to one time it, touch pass it, send it back? How long can you wait before making a decision?
Well, it varies from team to team. It all depends on how aggressive they are up top. Some teams are more aggressive than others. They come up higher on the point. But, you know, the kind of the key is to know what you're going to do before the puck gets to you. As whoever's out there, whether it be Gores or Worthington up top there, before the puck comes, I got to know I have Mo off on the flank, or depending on where their forward is in the middle. If he's playing over towards the flank more, then that's when you got to take it and rip it yourself. But you got to kind of look where that guy is before you get the puck and kind of play off of him.
In a lot of ways, the power play is set up for Mo to have that one timer from the left side. Do you have to fight the temptation of always giving it to him in that, you know, you got a pretty good shot as well?
Yeah, I mean, there's not really much temptation. Everyone knows how Mo can shoot it. He's had plenty of goals on a power play, and, you know, he's our key guy. And, you know, other teams know that too. So if they start to play him, that's when I look for my opportunity. But it's nice to set him up. He can really let it rip. And, you know, assists are just as good as goals to me. And I have no problem making a play and letting him get a shot in there.
As long as it ends up in the back of the net, that's all that counts. defense.
That's the biggest thing right there.
How tough is the pass for the one-timer? When it works perfectly, it all looks like a thing of beauty, but it can't be as easy as it looks, obviously.
Oh, no. I mean, you work out a lot in practice, and it's a lot to do with the board guy, too. He sends over a nice pass, and sometimes, you know, puck lock, it bounces up or whatnot. You just got to try to settle it down for him over there. And you just kind of, it's more, not really passing, more of just a tip or a deflection from the pass to get it over there.
Thursday night watching this group of defensemen, it looked like everybody was a bit more aggressive offensively, coming down the, you know, looking at least from the left side, coming down to the corner more. It looked like as a group, this defense is kind of pushing the offense.
Yeah, that's something, you know, we're looking forward to getting more aggressive and getting in there. I mean, look, we got some good scorers, some good point guys on defense there, some of the top guys, and that's one of the things we're looking for. I mean, down low, when we get them in the O-zone, teams like to wrap around on us. We like to get our D going, pinching on the wall, and the big thing there is it helps us out when we have the third forward high and covering for us, and that's when we know we can get aggressive. So it counts on everybody out there for us to do our thing, and we like to get out there as much as we can and make the plays, and that's, you know, a lot of scoring. You get your D up making plays, and it throws other teams off guard.
I was going to say, I think right now Mo is the leading scoring defenseman in Hockey East, but add you and Nick Schaus to the mix, and we've got three of the top 10 scoring defensemen in Hockey East. There's got to be a little bit of pride for this group in that.
Yeah, I mean, there's some pride there. All our defense, we're great skaters, and, you know, we get our feet moving, and we're able to get up in a play like that, and everyone's got good conditioning and feet, and we all got good playmakers there, and as long as we continue to stay aggressive in our D zone and not spend much time down there, we'll have a lot more energy to be able to play in offense.
At the same time, I guess one doesn't, you can't shirk your defensive responsibilities. Is there a temptation at times to think too much offense?
Yeah, that's one thing you got to be aware of. You don't want to take too many offensive reads to get on the wrong side of puck and give up odd man rushes like that. And we just got to continue, myself included, we got to get aggressive down low and get on them quicker, pin them on the boards, and just kind of disrupt their play down there.
Now, we've talked over the years about your offensive skills, and I guess I'd almost forgotten last night. Those two goals were the first two of the year. Did it take a little weight off your shoulders, get that out of the back of your mind?
Yeah, it's nice to get a few goals in there. I mean, it's been a while, obviously, all year, haven't had any. And, you know, I think I just kind of concentrate more on, you know, the defensive aspect, kind of shutting them down, and got to do a better job there. And, you know, things will go from there. A couple goals, yeah, it's nice, a little weight off the shoulder. But I think the big part to worry about is just defensively.
I guess we'll wrap this up. What's the best date movie you've ever taken anybody to? What's the best date movie?
The best date movie? Oh, probably, I don't know, comedy movies. I mean,
anyone in particular?
I mean, I went to Dodgeball when it was out a while ago. It was a pretty crowded movie, but I don't know, Bob. That's a tough question. I don't like that one.
All right. Let's see. Noting that you had the deflection, any good at pool or billiards or any good at pinball?
All right, well, I'll go back to the movie question now. I thought of one for that. You gave me enough time.
What's the best date movie you've ever seen?
Anything on Tuesday nights out here, because it's a discount night, cheap tickets all day, so Tuesday night movies, whatever's playing is a good date night movie. As for pool, you know, I play here or there, but probably can't make any shots like I did last night on the pool table, so.
I think we'd call you Wisconsin Slim.
Yeah, I heard about that one.
All right, Jeremy Dehner, keep going with the trick shots. We love it. The stanchion play works. We thank you very much for your time. We wish you continued success. We're going to do this again, I promise. Thank you.
All right, thanks, Bob.
That is Jeremy Dehner. You are listening to the Riverhawk Radio Network. Maury Edwards into the attack zone left side. Edwards down the left board, stops, holds. Across for Dehner, settles it down, backs away, moves to the middle. Dehner, left side, shot, score! And we're tied at a goal apiece. Jeremy Dehner, the shot.